the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Carol died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. And the white pall that is being placed upon Carol's casket is a symbol of baptism, a reminder to us that she spent her life clothed in Christ. was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Granted through this mystery, your servant Carol, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this for our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. And now we'll have the first reading.
Tears from our faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be seen, behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we live. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. From our sins, amen.
Amen.
I also want to just say this for my cousins that were raised by grandma and husband. She was such a giver, and she always opened her house up to everyone. We were just speaking about that. She loved cooking, she loved family. And grandma loved everyone here. Her heart was big enough to love everyone of us. No one is an exception. She loved each and every one of us. And it's an honor to be able to say it. And thank you for coming to her. To say goodbye.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He did not spare his own son, but handed him over to us all. Will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather, was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress, or persecution or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or the sword? No. In all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Just speaking on behalf of the seems like we can say goodbye to so many of our beloved parishioners in the past year, and today is no exception. Over the past few days since Carol's passing, so many people have told me in this parish what Carol meant to them, and what Carol meant to the parish itself. She was a pillar of the parish. She was greatly loved, and she loved this place in return. When I met with Alana and Alicia this past week to prepare for today, they both mentioned how dedicated Carol was to Saints Teresa and Bridget Parish, that she woke them up every Sunday for Mass, and at every Saturday event, she helped clean the church, she worked the toy drive, you name it, and in a very special way, she loved singing in the choir, and so our choir has lost a dear friend as well. And so today's funeral is very painful for our community in one way, but there is a wonderful reminder today as well, and that's the debt of gratitude we owe to people like Carol, who worked to make this parish what it is. She was certainly one of those people. When I asked Alana and Denise to describe Carol, what kind of mother, what kind of grandmother, what kind of friend she was, they immediately said she was very loving. They emphasized that. They also emphasized very heavily she would open up her doors to anyone in need. And so often she had people staying with her, living with her, because they'd fallen on hard times and they just needed a place where they could feel safe. How many people here lived with her one time or another? Amen. All these people look at her. It's incredible. God bless her. That speaks to the kind of Christian that Carol was. It also speaks to the kind of welcome Carol received into heaven, because Jesus teaches us that the one who opens the door on earth will have to find the door to heaven open for them. And Carol found an open door. We also said that Carol loved to pray, and she just loved to pray. And with a busy household, so many people coming and going and so forth, that sometimes she would go into the bathroom and close the door in order to pray by herself. And she thought that she had privacy there. She thought that no one could hear her pray. But Alana said that one day, one of the neighbor ladies said, "Girl, you can really pray. You're really good at it, so keep it up." And she realized it wasn't just God who was hearing her prayers. But Carol certainly had lots of reasons to pray, and certainly, those of you who knew her know what that means. Her obituary describes her. She had 6 kids. She lost 2 husbands. And in her lifetime, she also had that horrible pain of burying 2 of her children, Ricky and Karen. The Kenesha and Alana said that Carol loved her kids. She loved them so much. And they also said that she really, really loved her grandkids. They said that love came out in so many ways, entertaining them, playing paper dolls, listening to them, going shopping for them. And they said she got a lot of joy out of shopping for others. The generosity to those she loved gave her great joy. They also said she had a great sense of fun. And I noticed in the obituary, it said that she sometimes laughed herself breathless. And there's a beautiful line in that obituary that I'd like to lift up in particular. Her presence filled the room with joy, laughter, and love. She was more than just a mother, grandmother, and sister. She was a friend. She was a matriarch. She was our queen. Carol gave our lives meaning. She showed us what a phenomenal woman looked like today. That is quite a tribute. I also received a beautiful message from Alana about her mom that I would like to share with you. Mother, you gave the gift of life to us. And then, in love, you set us free. We thank you for all your tender care, for the deep, warm hugs, and always being there. Presence we miss, your memory we treasure, loving you always, forgetting you never. And as I read Alana's words, I just heard so many people express what kind of mother and grandmother, especially that Carol was, I thought of a reflection that was written in 1933, 1 year after Carol was born. And I would like to share this with you. It was written by Temple Bailey. It's called The Parable of Motherhood. The young mother sat with her foot on the path of life. "Is the way long?" she asked. And her guide said, "Yes, and the way is hard. And you will be old before you reach the end of it. But the end is better than the beginning." But the young mother was happy, and she would not believe that anything could be better than those years. So she played with her children, and gathered flowers for them along the way, and bathed them in the clear streams. And the sun shone on them, and life was good. The young mother cried, "Nothing will ever be lovelier than this." Then night came. The mother said, "This is better than the brightness of day, for I have taught my children courage." And the morning came, and there was a hill ahead, and the children climbed and grew weary, and the mother was weary. But at all times she said to the children, "A little patience, and we are there." So the children climbed, and when they reached the top, they said, "We could not have done it without your mother." And the mother, when she lay down at night, looked up at the stars and said, "This day is better than the last. My children have learned fortitude in the face of hardness. Yesterday I gave them courage, today I have given them strength." And with the next day came strange clouds which darkened the earth, clouds of war and hate and racism and evil. And the children groped and stumbled, and the mother said, lift up your eyes to the light." And the children looked up and saw above the clouds everlasting glory, and it girded them and brought them beyond the darkness. And that night the mother said, "This is the best day of all, for I have shown my children God." And the days went on, and the weeks, and the months, and the years, and the mother grew old, and she was little and bent, and her children were tall and strong and walked with courage. And when the way was rough, they lifted her, for she was as light as a feather. And at last they came to a hill, and beyond the hill they could see a shining road and golden gates flung wide. And the mother said, "I've reached the end of my journey, and now I know the end is better than the beginning, for my children can walk alone, and their children happy." And the children said, "You will always walk with us, mother, even when you have gone through the gates." And they stood and watched her as she went on alone, and the gates closed behind her. And they said, "We cannot see her, but she is with us still. A mother like ours is more than a memory. She is a living presence." Please stand for the prayers of the faithful. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead, sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. In baptism, Carol received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Our sister Carol was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Many people die by violence, war, racism, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Those who trust in the Lord and now speak in the Lord, give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Family and friends of Carol seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain. Dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives are purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the preparation of the gifts. Thank you.
present to you a sacrificial offering to the Lord for the salvation of your servant Carol. We beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Carol, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth you will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, that you all hold pleasing to you, that passing through this life, give kind images to your kingdom. May we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when we will see you as you are, and we will be like you for all the ages as you wipe away every tear, and we will praise you without end, in Christ our Lord, whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
journey. Mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Carol may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. And please be seated. At this point, I invite Teresa to please come forward.
Teresa, go ahead. Dear readers, do not falsely use these lessons. They are for good, peace, and happiness for all those that love Jesus, His mom. The divine instructions from the Holy Prophet, chapter 4, death and burial of Elizabeth, Matthew's lessons, the ministry of death. When John was 12 years old, his mother died, and neighbors laid her body in a tomb among her kindred. And near to Zechariah's tomb. And John was deeply grieved. He wept. Matthew said, "It is not well to weep because of death. Death is no enemy of man. It is a friend who, when the work of life is done, just cuts the cord that binds the human boat to earth, that it may sail on smoother seas. No language can describe a mother's worth, and yours was tried and true. But she was not called hence until her tasks were done. The calls of death are always for the best, for we are solving problems there as well as here. And one is sure to find himself where he can solve his problems best. It is but selfishness that makes one wish to call again to earth departed souls. Then let your mother rest in peace. Just let her noble life be strength and inspiration unto you. A crisis in your life has come, and you must have a clear conception of the work that you are called to do. The sages of the ages call you Barbara. The prophets look to you and say, he is Elijah, come again. Your mission here is that of Barbara, for you will go before the Messiah's face to pave his way and make the people ready to receive their king. This readiness is purity of heart. None but the pure in heart can recognize the king. To teach man to be pure in heart, you must yourself be pure in heart and word and deed. In infancy, the vow for you was made, and you became a Nazarite. The razor shall not touch your face nor head, and you shall taste not wine nor fiery drinks. Men need a pattern for their lives. They love to follow and not to lead. The man who stands upon the corners of the path and points the way but does not go is just a pointer, and a block of wood can do the same. The teacher treads the way. On every span of ground, he leaves his footprints clearly cut, which all can see and be assured that he, their master, went that way. Men comprehend the inner life by what they see and do. They come to Allah through ceremonies and forms. And so when you would make men know that sins are washed away by purity and life, a right symbolic may be introduced. In water, wash the bodies of the people who would turn away from sin and strive for purity and life. This rite of cleansing is a preparation rite, and they who thus are cleansed comprise the temple of purity. And you shall say, you men of Israel, hear, reform, and wash. Become the sons of purity, and you shall be forgiven. This rite of cleansing and this temple are but symbolic of the cleansing of the soul, which does not come from outward show, but is the temple within. Now, you may never point the way and tell the multitudes to do what you have never done, but you must go before and show the way. You want to teach that men must wash, so you must lead the way. Your body must be washed, symbolic of the cleansing of the soul. John said, why need I wait? May I not go up once and wash? Nathanael said, 'Tis well, and then they went down to the Jordan ford and east of Jericho, just where the host of Israel crossed when first they entered Canaan. They tarried for a time. Nathanael talked to Harbinger, and he explained to him the inner meaning of the cleansing rite and how to wash himself and how to wash the multitude. And in the river Jordan, John was washed. Then they returned to the wilderness. Now when Gaddis Hills, Nathanael's work was done, and he and John went down to Egypt. They rested not until they reached the temple of Saqqara in the valley of the Nile. For many years, Nathanael was a master in this temple of the brotherhood. When he told about the life of John and of his mission to the sons of men, the heretic with joy received the harbinger, and he was called the brother Nazarite. For 18 years, John lived and wrought within these temple gates. And here he conquered self, became a mastermind, and learned the duties of the harbinger. The one thing I want to talk about is this divine instruction that says, the teacher treads the way. On every bit of ground, he leaves his footprints clearly cut, which all can see and be assured that he, their master, went their way. One thing for certain, two things for sure. I know for a fact that my grandmother did everything through words, acts, and deeds, and it was a visual that she was love manifest, because that's all he would get and receive from her was love. Even with the laughter, the humor, the joy, whatever it was all in love. And so she paved the way and she showed the way. And so if you know the way, because you were there to know the way, cleanse yourself and continue to be the message that you bring. Be exactly what I know is left for us, showing us what it is to love through family. It don't take much. Just a little bit of something is everything, because we are part of every part. It's love, and that just means peace. But for the most part, she gave us what we needed, which was a clear direction of how to go about loving each other. And that's how she left, in that same direction. I came the same way I came. No, I came the same way I... Wait a minute. I leave the same way I came. In peace and in love.
Good morning, or should I say afternoon. I want to thank the family of Mrs. Blount. Even though she was my very good friend and my mentor, and I was her Eucharistic minister, I took communion to her each Sunday. And each Sunday we would pray together. And we would start the prayer with the Hail Mary. And we would continue on with the Our Father. And it often puzzled me that every time we ended, she would always say, Lord, bless my family and my friends. And it kind of bothered me at first, because I'm like, we're here praying for you, why are you praying for others? But that's the type of person she was. She was very loving, very giving. She would often, Joan and Tammy, you all know, she loved her sisters and brothers. She was so happy, and she would tell me about each and every event that took place with the family. And not too long ago, I think it was at her brother's house, I found out this morning that you all had a family celebration. And she thought that she was not well enough to attend, and she went. And she came back, and she shared all the love, joy, and fun that she had. She was actually in tears that she had a chance to celebrate with her family. Kanisha, I want to thank you. She told me that you were ready to give up everything and bring her into your home to take care of her. She loved that for you. Arisha, you were her battler. you would break a brick over your grandmother. She told me about an incident that happened here twice. We'll laugh and talk about that later. I'm not going to tell anybody. Chris, I take my hat off to you. I know that you live like in St. Peter's or somewhere, St. Charles, somewhere out 70. She said it was 4 hours. But you gave of your time to come down on Sunday mornings to pick her up and to drive her all the way back to your area, all the way from the city to the county, to have prayer with you at your church. and she loved you for that. I thank you, Jeremy, who happens to be my godson because of Mrs. Blount. She made sure that I was his godmother, and he was there busy with her on several Sundays that I came. And I thank you for the care that you showed your grandmother. You know, I'm going to tell you about the pots and pans, that the pot holders and the dish towels and everything that she did. And she was like, she's doing so well up in New York. She was so very proud. I think she was at peacetime in Durham because she knew that her family was at peace. Her family that she loved dearly. I loved her. Can't nobody take that away. It's over 60 years of friendship, from bingo to church. I mean, yeah, we went to bingo, to parties, to a little of everything. But with all of that, she always kept you guys first. Family was first. And I hope you all carry that love on you throughout, even to her oldest son. She made sure that I knew each and every person in her family, so that I could say to you all, much love, and she is in peace. Thank you.
The funeral director informed me we must be at the cemetery at 1 p.m. and some enrollments that will be offered at the celebration that follows. And so I invite James Tools to please come.
Certainly we honor the Lord on this day. And in spite of whatever the circumstances might be, he's yet worthy, isn't he?
Yes.
I'd like to also invite you, Father, and to all of you, my precious, precious family. Certainly to the children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren. And if I may, because we've always been taught that, I'd like to recognize we have four elders in the midst. We always want to love on them and reverence them while God is yet allowing them yet to remain with us. If I may, Sir Alfred Haynes. And we'd like to do it in order, so now give God forgive me. Next would be Queen Joan Johnson. Queen Shirley Bayes. And last but certainly not least, Sir Melvin Bayes. We're so thankful for you. I was reared at a time when children were told to be seen and not heard. But I thank God that my big cousin, Carol, was actually my mother's first cousin. I can recall us coming back after my mother died. We came back to St. Louis, my siblings and I, and we had the distinct opportunity and privilege of being reared by Carol's grandmother and aunt. Her grandmother, the illustrious and feisty Fanny Mariah Howard Lee, and her sister, Georgia Howard. Their home and our home would be the gathering place for Pokino. Some of you remember what Pokino, I don't know about. For any family celebration and repast, we did it there in the yard, on the porch, in the house. We didn't rent halls then, because we were just thankful to be with family. Although it would sometimes be a sad occasion, it was a good occasion because we were family, loving on each other and supporting them. In the midst of those hundreds of people, a little insignificant kid like me, Carol, I was probably about 8 years old, Carol saw through all of that and looked at me. Again, children were to be seen and not heard. But she always had love. She spoke to me and loved on me, and I never forgot it. I could be in a room of 200, 300, 400 people, and I always made my way until this day to see Carol if I saw her in the room, to love on her, because she always did that to all of us. Always a smile, always a kind word. And we shall never forget that Carol Higgins Blount passed our wedding, and that we are much better and much blessed and thankful for her that she was along our journey. Will you all please forgive me? I didn't know until this morning when I got here. And Alana, well, I had to realize I had to do the process of elimination because we officially call it tiny. But I said, Alana must be tiny. So and she told me what my big cousin, my big cousin, requested. So I'm going to be obedient to her request. But you all pray with me as I attempt to sing the song because it's been a minute. Why should I feel
assured and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Carol in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servants, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ Jesus and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And in peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.